Now we're ready to start the heart of the course, which is the study of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So, as with all mathematical concepts, there are three questions you have to ask yourself. When you get a new idea, what is it, how do you compute it, and what's it good for? Now, this video is going to be all about what is it, the definitions of eigenvalues and eigenvectors. And then the next video is going to be how do you compute it, and what's it good for is going to be most of the rest of the course, although we saw a fair amount of that already in Chapter 1, the decoupling principle. Eigenvalues and eigenvectors are all about decoupling matrices and linear transformations. Okay, so there's one definition for matrices and another for linear transformation, for linear operators. So let's do the matrices first. So let's suppose we have a square matrix, an n by n matrix, and we have a non-zero vector. And if it happens that the matrix times a vector is a multiple of the vector, that is, the matrix times a vector is pointing the same direction as the vector, then we call the vector an eigenvector, and we call the scalar multiple an eigenvalue. So for example, let's start off with one of the simplest matrices you could write down, just a diagonal matrix with 1, 0, 0, 2. 1, 0 is an eigenvector because if you multiply 1, 0, 0, 2 by 1, 0, you get 1, 0. So 1, 0 is an eigenvector with eigenvalue 1. 0, 1 is an eigenvector with eigenvalue 2 because you multiply A times 0, 1, you get 0, 2. On the other hand, 1, 1 isn't an eigenvector at all. It's not an eigenvector because if you multiply the matrix by 1, 1, you get 1, 2, and that's not a multiple of 1, 1. In general, most vectors are not going to be eigenvectors, and most numbers are not going to be eigenvalues. It's only very special vectors and very special numbers are going to be eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Okay. Now, if you have an eigenvalue and an eigenvector, any multiple of that eigenvector is still going to be an eigenvector. And we can ask, what are all of the eigenvectors associated with a particular eigenvalue? So in other words, what are all the solutions to Ax equals lambda x? And we call that an eigenspace. Now, strictly speaking, there is one solution to this equation that is not an eigenvector. The zero vector is in every eigenspace, but in our definition of eigenvectors, we had to say a non-zero vector, because of course the zero vector satisfies this equation for every value of lambda. That's cheating. We're interested in non-zero vectors to be eigenvectors, but zero does count as being in the eigenspace. So let's look again at our matrix 1, 0, 0, 1. The eigenspace with eigenvalue 1 is all multiples of 1, 0. So there it is in red, the eigenspace E1. The eigenspace with eigenvalue 2 is 0, is all multiples of 0, 1. So there is E2. So what this operator does, what this matrix does, is it stretches things by a factor of 1 in the horizontal direction. It stretches things by a factor of 2 in the vertical direction. And if you take any vector that's not horizontal or vertical, if you take that vector to be x, then ax will not be parallel to x. And since it's not parallel, this is not an eigenvector. The only eigenvectors are in E1 or in E2. Okay. And again, remember, 0 does not count as an eigenvector, but it is in every eigenspace. Okay, that's it for matrices. Let's talk about linear operators. So let's suppose we have a vector space V and a linear operator that sends V to itself. And we have a non-zero vector, which has a property that when you feed it to L, you get a multiple of what you started from. Well, then V is called an eigenvector, and lambda is called an eigenvalue. It's really the same definition that we had for matrices, It's just that instead of saying A times x, we say L of v. So for example, let's suppose that we had the space of smooth complex valued functions of a real variable. And then L will be the derivative. If you think about the function e to the 3t, the derivative of e to the 3t is 3e to the 3t. So this is an eigenvector of the derivative operator with eigenvalue 3. And if you look at the function cosine t plus I sine t, that's an eigenvector with eigenvalue I. Let's see why. If you take its derivative of cosine is negative sine, derivative of I sine is I times cosine, and what you get is I times cosine plus I sine. So this is a function whose is an eigenvector with eigenvalue 3. This is an eigenvector with eigenvalue I. Okay, so those are the definitions. Now this happens to be an infinite dimensional vector space. Let's look at a finite dimensional vector space. Let's suppose that a vector space has a basis with n elements in it, so it's an n-dimensional vector space, and it should behave more or less like Rn. And I claim that by looking at the matrix of L, the matrix of L is an n by n matrix. And you can ask, what are the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of that n by n matrix? And I claim the eigenvalues of that matrix are exactly the eigenvalues of the linear operator. And the eigenvectors of that matrix are the coordinates of the eigenvectors of the linear operator. So if you can find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the matrix, you have essentially found the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors of the operator. And the reason is, if we want to find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the operator, we want to find non-zero vectors that satisfy this equation. But something satisfies this equation if, you know, L of V equals lambda V, if and only if the coordinates of L of V are the same as the coordinates of lambda V. And how do you get the coordinates of L of V? Well, you take the coordinates of V and you multiply by the matrix of L. And how do you get the coordinates of lambda V? Well, that's just lambda times the coordinates of V. So V is an eigenvector with eigenvalue lambda if and only if the coordinates of V give you an eigenvector of this matrix with the same eigenvalue. So we're going to develop a whole bunch of techniques for figuring out eigenvalues and eigenvectors of matrices. And then whenever you're given a linear operator, you just find the matrix of that operator and apply the same techniques, and you'll find the eigenvalues and eigenvectors of the operator.